So climate change was an urgent problem 20 years ago, and today we are really down to the last minutes of an ability to come to grips with it. So climate change will have profound consequences in every dimension of human life and of the natural systems that support us. But just to take the oceans, which are after all 70% of the Earth's surface, the oceans are already absorbing most of the heat that we produce and 30% of the CO2 that we produce. So they have, over the last several decades, it buffered us against the impacts of climate change. The effects of greenhouse gas emissions, the emissions that cause climate change, are twofold in the ocean. One is heat, right? Is that as we warm the climate, we are warming the ocean. But the second is acidification, that as we pump out more and more CO2 and it's absorbed by the ocean, it also changes the pH of those waters. That as waters warm, fish stocks move to more familiar temperatures. And that means that communities that have relied on a fish stock for perhaps centuries will suddenly find it's no longer there. A changing climate will have profound implications for food security in many parts of the world. It's estimated as many as 3 billion people depend on seafood for a significant part of their protein. And therefore, any threat to the productivity of fisheries is something to be concerned about. One of the implications of climate change is that we have to get better than ever at managing the resources upon which we depend, because those resources will be in upheaval. And that means that we have to be really good at managing fisheries, and that means we have to make sure we are tackling problems like illegal fishing, which undermine that management. So we now have sensors in the water around the world. We have satellites in space that can track what's happening on the surface and even look below. And we are increasingly getting the capability to know what the condition of ocean resources are and what people are doing with those resources in a way that we wouldn't have dreamed of 10 years ago. And that's revolutionizing our ability to manage fisheries, for example, because we can track boats across the water. But it will also revolutionize our ability to manage the health of ocean resources, as we're in a position to anticipate stresses as they come and to manage those stresses much more effectively. Here at Stanford, we're committed to working all the way from insight to impact, which means we invest, of course, in research to advance the frontiers of knowledge, to generate new insights that can help us meet these challenges. But we also engage with partners across the world to translate those insights into change in the water. And that means we're working with some of the world's leading fishing companies. We're working with some of the world's leading conservation NGOs. We're working with heads of state who can be all part of the solution, guided by the insights that we generate.